Well, Sandy's rude arrival interrupted what would have been the big story this week, the upcoming presidential election. 11 News reporter Sarah Sampson is live in our newsroom with more on how the storm is impacting the final push to the polls. Sarah.
Well, Donna, because this is such a rare scenario, it's hard to tell just how the storm will affect things next Tuesday. But elections officials say, at least here in Maryland, the impact should be minimal.
For the past 2 days, the images of Sandy's path of destruction have been inescapable. A historic storm just a week before a historically close election.
This is pretty unprecedented, especially in recent times, as far as I can remember.
That's why it's difficult to determine exactly how Sandy will impact the election, if at all. Ross Goldstein of the Maryland Board of Elections is optimistic.
I think it's going to be really minimized. We've had a lot of cooperation from the governor's office, from MEMA, the Maryland Emergency Management Authority, and other individuals.
From flooding on the eastern shore to heavy snow in Garrett County, Sandy has brought a diverse set of challenges for elections officials. Goldstein says there are a handful of early voting sites across America in miniature running on generators. And for Election Day, there's a backup plan.
We have paper ballots available to be deployed, you know, should that be needed.
Early voting hours have been extended. Locations will now be open 8 a.m. to 9 p.m. through the end of the week. Friday is a makeup day for Monday. There is also more time to vote by absentee.
The absentee ballot application deadline has been extended until tomorrow night.
But no doubt the storm at least threw a curveball at the pre-election plans, like efforts to get out the vote.
Whether that's having rallies or having any kind of strategy meetings or things like that. So those things could possibly have been delayed, although there still is enough time to recover in time for next week.
National polling agencies Rasmussen and Gallup suspended polling during the storm. When they do resume, it's unclear how Sandy will impact the final presidential polls.
I'm still sure they'll be able to get a decent sample size, which is really the issue, but at the same time, there are some people who are very unreachable, obviously.
President Obama has said the election is not his top priority right now.
I am not worried at this point about the impact on the election. I'm worried about the impact on families.
But if disaster relief doesn't go well, the president's campaign could suffer. Meanwhile, Republican nominee Mitt Romney has also taken time off the campaign trail to help with relief efforts. In a primary debate, he said he believes disaster relief should be shifted to the states. But he didn't answer reporter questions about that today.
You've been asked 14 times today what you do with FEMA. What's your response? Why don't you answer any questions?
Again, early voting in Maryland resumes tomorrow through this Friday, November 2nd. The polls will be open from 8 a.m. to 9 p.m. The governor's office says anyone in line at 9 p.m. will get to cast their ballot. For a list of early voting sites around the state, just head to our website, WBALTV.com. Reporting live from the newsroom, Sarah Sampson, WBAL-TV, 11 News.